So everyone, I am now live at the Cana, not quite sure how they pronounce it, Winery. This is in Middleburg. And it's just gorgeous out here. We're preparing for our wine tasting as a part of our time out session. So this is the grounds of the vineyard. You can probably see the grapes growing in the distance. And I'm waiting for my tasting. We're gonna get hardworking. We get included in your tasting. You get your wine glass. And these are the 8 wines that we will be tasting. Pretty good $10 tasting fee for 8 wines. And you also get the glass. Hello, Living Free. So we're just waiting for our tasting to start. It's supposed to start at 4:30. So it should be starting shortly. But I wanted to just show you the grounds in the interim. I heard that the view from the gazebo area up top is beautiful. But this is the entranceway to the vineyard and winery. Again, it's beautiful out here. Here are your tasting sections. They had a sign out front about sangria slushies. So check this out. Sign up for tasting inside. Sangria slushies in red, white, and blueberry. How awesome does that sound? So I'm very excited to do the wine tasting. We actually packed a picnic lunch. It's kind of, well, I guess it's lunch. It's like early dinner, late lunch. We packed a picnic from Market Salamander. And so we have sandwiches and lots of goodies in our bag. So these are our bags. Got some crab cake sandwiches and ham sandwiches and Thai salad, pasta salad. So we got some good things going on. Again, this is the view of the vineyard. I mean, it's just so amazing, you guys. Look at that, just gorgeous. Hi, Jinyar, thanks for joining. I am at the vineyard for some wine tasting. I mean, the view alone is amazing. And the building is gorgeous. Everyone's just sort of sitting and enjoying themselves. Are we ready? Oh, time for some tasting! So we're about to get the tasting started.
Don't do wine. You got your glass and red.
And what is this for? Check off?
Yeah. So we're going to check off the different wines so we can see what we like and what we don't like.
Okay, let me go get the pool at the station.
Okay.
Let's see here what we got. She went to go get another sheet. There are 4 of us doing a tasting, so we're going to check off as we taste.
Okay, so thank you all for coming to Cana. Have you been here before?
Nope, yes. First time.
Okay, my name is Kristen. I'll be giving you a tasting. We're a fairly new winery. We've been open for... we've been open for 3 years. Les Bell and his wife Karen and their daughter Annette are the owners. And they bought the property in 2011. It was a plot of land. There was nothing here before. So it's all brand new. And they named it after Cana of Galilee in the Bible, where Jesus performed his first miracle, turning water into wine. And since we're mere mortals, we have to use grapes. We have about 7.5 acres under vine. We're growing Cabernet Franc, Petit Verdot, Viognier, Petit Mansaigne, Merlot, Norton, and Tannat. We're hoping to harvest the Petit Verdot, Petit Mansaigne, a little bit of the Viognier this year for the first time. It's going to be a very small amount. We hope to have our first little harvest. In the meantime, we've been buying grapes from other vineyards and having the wine come in here. So we bring the grapes and juice to our production facility and make the wine. Most of the grapes, all the grapes come from within the United States, some from Virginia and some from out of state. We have a grape shortage in Virginia with all the new wineries opening.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
And they all need grapes, and we need grapes.
Yeah.
So the demand is way up here, and the supply is way down there.
Can't have grape shortages.
Yeah, so the best way to get Virginia grapes is to grow them yourself, mm-hmm.
Wow.
So this is our Gewürztraminer. And
this is the first one. Gewürztraminer.
Yeah, Gewürztraminer is from the Alsace region of France, right up on the German border. So it's a heavily German-influenced area of France. And this is a dry Gewürztraminer. The Alsatian Gewürztraminer tend to be dry. And the German Gewürztraminer tend to be sweeter. So Gewürz means spicy. The Traminer is a kind of grape, so it's spicy grape.
Mm. That's not bad for dry rind.
Mm-hmm.
Not drunk at all. Not bad. Dry wine.
Mm-hmm. I feel the spicy.
Me too.
The ladies are wine tasting. Wine tasting. That wasn't bad. Let's see what the rest of them are. They have for us.
This is our, we have a sweeter wine. We have some sweeter wines as well. We have the Rhapsody White, which is a little sweeter. It's the last one I'm tasting. This is our Vidal Blanc. The Vidal Blanc, this is a dry version of Vidal Blanc, and it was aged in oak. So it was also underwent malolactic fermentation, and that converts malic acid, and that's the acid that naturally occurs in grapes, and it's very tart tasting, to lactic acid, which is the dairy acid. So it's going to be soft, it's going to be creamy, it's going to be buttery, kind of like an oak-aged Chardonnay.
This has like a grapefruit.
A little bit, some pear, pineapple. Mm. The one that really has the grapefruit is our Traminette.
Is this where I can I do this here?
I don't think I like that one as much. Mm-hmm. I think I like the first one better. You like this one better?
Yeah, a little milder.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep, bottoms up.
And this is our rosé. This is going to be slightly sweeter. It's at 1% residual sugar, and the others are less than 0.5%.
It's not as good as the first one.
And this one is made from Tempranillo, which is a Spanish varietal, and some Chamberson. And you're going to get some notes of cherry and strawberry. It's going to be very fruit forward.
Rosé. What's the percentage like as far as
the percentage of
like the grapes, alcohol?
I'm not sure what percent Tempranillo, what percent Chamberson.
Okay.
The alcohol is at
12.2. Okay. 12.2%.
And it's 1% residual sugar.
Yeah. You're welcome, Periscopian Master.
So that's the rosé.
Hmm.
And it is on the drier side.
The rosé is pretty tasty. Glad I'm not driving.
I'm telling you.
That was okay. The rosé was okay.
Well,
Periscopian Master, we get only 8 with the tasting. So for the $10 tasting, these are the options. So I might be kind of out of luck with anything much stronger. But the rosé was okay. I'm going to put a check mark by that one. I didn't like that second one. This one was okay. Let's see what's next.
Yeah, this is the next one is our Cabernet Franc. And this one's kind of interesting. It's very spicy. It's light body, but rather bold and spicy.
Is that a Merlot? That's a Merlot?
That's the Cabernet Franc.
Okay.
So it's the
not like tacos.
On the tasting sheet. And I call it Kung Fu Cabernet Franc because it has a real kick to it.
It's supposed to have a kick to it. Let's see.
Where's the forming?
I'm going to let everybody else taste it first before I...
No.
Okay, here we go. Kung Fu Kick.
Kung Fu Kick on.
Ooh. Nah. I'm going to drink it, but nah.
Yeah, it's one of the people either really like or they really don't.
That's
spicy.
A negative. Cabernet Franc.
Mm-hmm.
Put an X by that one, y'all. Yeah. All right, that's 1, 2, 3, 4 down. 4 to go. I heard that the dessert wine is really good, so I'm waiting on that.
Yeah. And this is the Armor Low. And, yeah. Which one are you looking for? Yeah, that's really good.
X in this case means no. Check mark means yes.
This is our Merlot. It's not quite as spicy. I think it'll be a little bit nicer, a little bit calmer for you all than the Cabernet Franc.
All right, swirl. Swirl for flavor. You don't like that one either?
No.
Yeah, these are a little bit drier, heavier red.
All right, let's catch my expression on this one. Thanks for the hearts, guys. Salut. It's better than the last one, but not my favorite.
This is apple wine.
Get it out the glass, y'all. Get it out the glass.
A little bit to get the red wine out of your glass.
Now, which one is this?
This is apple wine, and I'm just pouring a little bit to get rid of the red.
All right, this is where we are. Tastes like rotten potatoes. I don't know what it tastes like. Apple wine. You saying the apple wine tastes like rotten potatoes?
I think I've been tart.
Oh, thanks for the hearts, everybody.
Yeah.
All right, let's try the apple wine.
I think I've been tart.
I think I need some chocolate or something in between here or something to clear my palate.
I didn't know what that I had been, but I think I had been.
The apple wine.
I think somebody needs to send me a horse so I can get back home.
Then your what?
Give me a horse.
Okay.
I don't know what that was.
That was Merlapple.
Oh. That was just clear. Okay. That wasn't a choice. That was to clear the palate, people. Then we're going to try the apple wine.
Yeah, that was to clear the red wine out of your glass.
Yeah.
Oh. All right. Here we go. Apple wine.
Yeah.
Blueberry apple wine.
See, there's a reason why we didn't bottle this Merlapple.
Oh. Nope.
You guys are going to like the last one.
I mean, I like the 2013 Rosé.
Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah.
And the first one actually wasn't bad for a dry wine either.
Like champagne.
Yeah.
So this one's a tiny bit sweeter, the blueberry apple.
Let me finish this off.
And this is apple wine with some blueberry juice added after fermentation. And a little, not quite as tart as the apple wine.
All right, this is blueberry apple wine. Crisp apple and sweet blueberry.
Watery.
It's very light, very delicate. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I might can take that somewhere. No, I like it better than the one that burned me in my chest.
I can feel that one.
Yeah,
not one of my favorites.
You should call the police on that one. That's a fire department.
And this one is like flat. I have no feelings about this one.
Okay, now this one is.
All right, last one, y'all.
Rhapsody
in White is the last one.
And this one's gonna be,
I think I'm looking forward to the frozen sangrias.
It's another Vidal Blanc, but it's done differently than the first one. The first one was dry and oak aged. This was stainless steel, and it's about 1.5% residual sugar.
Oh, okay. Stainless steel. Here we go.
All right. Does that mean you kick it?
We have some other sweeter wines that aren't on the tasting that I'll tell you about. The Rhapsody in Red is 2% residual sugar, and it's Pinot Noir, Cabernet Franc, Cabernet Sauvignon. But it's not going to be that spicy Cabernet Franc.
It's okay.
It's a good bit sweeter. And we have a Riesling as well. So the Riesling is about 3.5% residual sugar. It's got some acidity, so it might not taste quite as sweet as that, but it's very nice.
So what's the results, people? Let's see. Out of the 8 wines, I believed I liked the 2013 Gerichtsmeiner. Is that how?
Gerichtsmeiner.
Gerichtsmeiner. And the 2013 Rosé with not so strong third place coming in, maybe with the Rhapsody in White. So that's the wrap up for me.
Are you posting this on a blog?
This is Periscope.
I think I'm going to get the 2013.
So I'm going to sign off for now until we get to those frozen sangrias. I'm kind of looking forward to trying those. I'm going to ask some questions about those. So which are you offering in the sangrias? Could you kind of go through those?
It's the Rhapsody in White, the Blueberry Apple, and the Rhapsody in Red. The last one you had in the tasting, the Rhapsody White, we have that. And it's going to be sweeter than the wine by itself.
Okay.
Because we mix it with a sangria mix.
Ah.
And then it's in water, and then it's frozen.
Okay.
And you know, then we have the Rhapsody in Red, which really does taste like a red sangria.
Oh.
Very fruity, sweeter. And then we have the Blueberry Apple, and it does taste sweeter.
I'm thinking maybe that Rhapsody in Red, if you're looking for like the real sangria, sweet, okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm. White's kind of white sangria. But I'll go with
the red. So can you tell me a little bit about, because this is our first time here, like the facility and like the different places to sit, because we kind of like...
Seating is it's family friendly in the first floor.
Okay.
That means kids and dogs are allowed. Okay. Upstairs, it's adults only. And so if you're in a nice, peaceful place without kids running around or dogs barking, you can go upstairs. We have some great views, especially from the gazebo. You can see our vineyard.
Okay.
You can see a really good view of all of our vineyard, the mountains.
I think that's where we might head.
And downstairs, you have a tasting bar. Bar. And we have more seating. And upstairs, on the balcony, we've got some seating. And then in the room in there, which is usually open to the public. Sometimes we have private events.
Okay. So what's the best view from the gazebo on this side?
Yeah, the gazebo, if it's not currently occupied.
Okay, okay.
Sometimes people like to stake out the gazebo.
Yep.
They have to sit there and get the view. But there's nice views from elsewhere on the deck as well.
Where do we order our frozen?
That you will order inside where you sign up for your tasting.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. All right. Thank you so much for your time.
And where do you purchase the wine at?
Yes. Okay. You purchase everything at that.
Gotta figure out how to get to the gazebo. Okay. And the gazebo, can I get to that from up here?
Yes. Okay. Inside or outside.
And is it the once I get up to the top, or is it like another level?
No, it's
up to the top, and I'll see it.
And then it's you just go straight.
Okay. Let me go scope it out, see if there's space in the gazebo. All right, it's my glass right here.
Okay.
Put my glass down. I'll put my thing in my bag.
And let's go see. Let's see if I can figure this out.
You can leave it here.
Well, if y'all gonna be bringing bags up, I'm just gonna stay up there and hold a spot.
Oh, okay.
So,
how are we gonna know if it's good?
I think I'm going to just send you a text message.
Oh. Okay.
So, I'll take my glass with me.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, we're gonna go try to find a gazebo so we can eat our packed picnic lunches that we brought. So, join me. I hear the views are great. Let's see. Get up a little higher so you guys can see. Look at the views of the winery. It looks like the gazebo is available. Let's see.
Oh,
I think I see a spot for us on the other side of the gazebo. Oh wow, look how beautiful this is, everybody. This is like freaking gorgeous. How beautiful. Cana Vineyards. Gorgeous. I'm going to lock down the table for us right here. So, thanks for joining me for the wine tasting. And I'm about to call the rest of my guests up here. And we're going to enjoy our lunch and have some sangria. So, I can't stop the broadcast.